Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden 20 video, guys. It's the third one of the day. We're knocking out these videos, and now we're grinding, trying to get as much Madden content as we can with this limited trial without my main account. Guys, if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe. We are doing pretty well so far with two videos out on a third that starts... Everyone, before I even say all that, make sure to like the video, because I'll be giving away 15K if I get 150 likes on this one. I did 50, 100, and 150. So if any of these videos cross any of those things, once I do my bundle pack opening, I got my coins, I'll be giving away to a random commenter if we hit that amount of likes. So smack the like button, guys. Comment down below. Say what's up. All you guys who are back from last year that I haven't talked to in a while, say what's up. And let's get into this video, guys. So... Before, I have a bundle opening coming your way, guys, so don't forget. Smack the like button, all my free videos I'm going to be posting, and if I hit a certain like goal, like I said in the last two videos, I will be posting a bundle pack opening. The only issue is that my main account is currently not able to play. Apparently, if you pre-ordered the game on your Xbox and you downloaded it, you're not able to access the game right now, and it's really freaking annoying, and you can't do it, so I'm on a side account, which means I can only show you guys like tips, tricks, and whatever I can do right now, but I really can't go into much else as far as playing the game, because that's not my main account. But guys, let's go over the objective list and all the missions and everything, because I know that's always a big part of every year of Madden. So I love always checking it out. It always gives you free stuff. I think it's a really cool area to always start with when you're playing the game. So you head over to right here, Mutt Dedication. So this is one of them. So there's the daily mission levels 3 through 15. So if you guys know what this is, it's like last year, the daily pack. You know, typically you had your two objectives and then the third objective, and you did those. You got a quick sell, a training quick sell, you know, and so on and so forth. So this is it, but obviously per level it increases. So this set is going to be 3 to 15. After 3 to 15, it's going to be 15 to 30, and as you keep increasing your levels, you get better rewards. So just like last year, it's complete three daily tasks. The three daily tasks are as follows: win one game, win two games, purchase a pack. What's also really cool is you can click into them this year. So you click in, you can actually go directly to one. So let's say, oh, okay, I gotta win one game, let me go play a solo challenge. Ultimate challenges sends you right into it. This is going to be good for later in the year, if you guys think about it, when you guys, like, it says like go purchase this or go complete this, and you're, everyone's like, wait, which challenge do I have to complete? What do I have to do? You can click right into it. It's interactive. There's one a second game, so on and so forth. You see the rest of these: Mud Champs, Ranked Draft, Solo Battles, Headset Seasons, and Ultimate Challenges. Then you got purchase a pack. Purchase any pack from the store to earn 50 coins. So you guys didn't know already, you do now. It's the same thing as last year: two games and a pack. Then there's the daily engagement milestones. So if you guys know what this is just like, remember last year when to get the Ryan Shazier token for your Mutt Master, you need to have, I believe it was like 15 days or 20 days of completing your mission, all your daily objective in a row. So it's like that. So to complete your first one, you get 1,000 coins. Complete your 5 in a row, 1,000 coins. Complete 10 in a row, that's how you get your power pass. Complete 15 in a row, 1,500. Complete 20, 1,500. 25, 82 to 84 overall power pass. So this implies by days, right? So if you do 25 days straight, you get an 82 to 84 overall power pass. So that's going to be like mid-August. If you do 37, that's going to be end of August, 4,000 coins. 50 is going to be an 85 to 86 overall power pass. Now, what does suck about this that I am realizing now is that if you don't play Madden consistently, or you take like a month or two off, you might not be able to complete some of the higher ones, which you're going to see soon what I'm trying to say. So now, 62, this is going to be about 2 months from now. So it's going to be like late September, if my math is correct. 4,000 coins. Beginning of like October, there's going to be 87, 88 overall power pass, which the overalls are falling right in line. The only thing I have a concern with is if these are daily missions. Let's say you don't play for a week, or you miss a day. You don't play every day. Like, you play like 4 days a week. You're not going to be able to complete these. You're going to complete these very, very late, which I don't... I hope there's a way that you can, like, make up daily challenges somehow, because other than that, that's going to kind of suck. 6,000 coins for this one. This one is... I guess it is called engagement milestone, so it's meant... What EA is trying to do here is trying to get people to play as much as possible so that the game doesn't die out. They want people on here every day, spending money, engaging in the game. Now, this is the 89 to 90 overall. This is 100 days. So there's going to be about, let's see, 3 months from today, just about. So August, September, October. It's going to be about early November. Late October, early November, just around about there. For the 89 to 90s, that means that players are going to be around slightly over... about slightly over 90 overall come this time. And then there's 112, 6,000 coins. There's 125, which is 91 to 92 overall power pass, which is 125 days. That's literally like 4 months away. It's like almost Christmas. So I guess that makes about sense when I told you guys about the Ghost of Future Past and stuff. Those cards are typically 93s and 94s. So it makes sense that we're going to get a 91 to 92 overall power pass. So the timing of it makes sense, but I don't really like how you have to do it every day. Because for any of you guys who are no money spent, you guys aren't the bit, you guys are grinders, but like you can't always play all the time. You have lives, a family, a job. This isn't easy for everyone. Now let's go to 150 days of 93 to 94 overall power pass. That is literally like, let's see, that's like January. And then 8,000 coins, 95 overall power pass. That's like February. February going on to March, somewhere in between there. And then we got 10,000 coins, which is kind of low coin totals at this point in the game. A 96 overall power pass is 200 days. Wow. So it's going to be around March. And then you got 10,000, 97 overall power pass, going to be 230. So around April is when we're going to have 97 overalls, around 98 overalls, 99 overalls. So we'll probably have 99 overalls right after the Super Bowl like usual. Typically, the Super Bowl is the first 99 overall. So that this all lines up perfectly. But this game, the game's probably already close to dying at this point. So now at this point, it's a 98 overall power pass, 260. We're probably already almost towards May. Because obviously, if you go towards the end, which is the 99 overall, that is 300 days. There's 364 days in the year, 365. And don't kill me for that. So that's going to be a year from today, which is going to be the end of July. So 330 is June and May is 300. So we're going to get a 99 overall power up pass around May. But at that point, the game's usually dead. We can only hope it won't be. But who knows with EA. Now there's plenty more. So let me keep going. There's going to be, let's see, the career stats like last year, which is people. It's very hard to finish all these. But what these are pretty much meant for is you get like coins and rewards for completing partial amounts of them. So 750 career stats stars earned. You're going to get a reward for 1.5k career stars earned. You get a reward. So on and so forth. Like, typically, you might not hit the max number. I did not mean to click into that. I forgot they're interactive. Typically, you won't hit the max number because it's just very hard to grind that far. But you get them per rewards. I don't know if these are all. I don't know if these are the completion is going to be 12.5k. Or it's just that hard. Let's see. I'd say it wins 5k. It's a lot. Career passing yards, 950k. Yeah, so I think these are like just like last year. You per set, as you see on the right, 50k, 100k, 200k. 350k, 650k, 950k are all going to be where you get rewards. So take that as you will. Some are going to be a lot harder than others. Some will be easier. Like passing yards won't be too hard. Rushing yards will be a little harder depending on how you play the game. But you get the point on those. Now let's head over to there should be the series progression. So this is the Mutt level rewards. So at level 5, you know, you get a theme selector, a quick sell. Gold player. So let's see when the rewards start getting good. In my opinion, the training right here, level 9 and level, that is 50 training. That's not too good. That's a decent power pass because the overalls are lower this year. So you could literally get a decent power pass with an 81 overall card. Now, a level 11 is when it starts. So you can get a Kittle here, a Juju Smith, or a Cam Newton. Also, a training quick sell or a coin quick sell. And there's going to be more stuff in that pack. It only just shows two on the front. But let's see when the real rewards start. Okay, a pro pack. So level 10 and level 11 and 12 are going to be really cool. Let's see. I'm going to really like 10k right there, so level 14 is going to be good. Level 15 is going to be good again. Level 16, we're getting Joey Bosa, I believe Darius Leonard, and that might be Everson Griffin or Aaron Kendricks. I always mess that up. That one's pretty good. Gold player pack. Let's see. Let's get to the good ones. We got Saquon. That's going to be an awesome one. I'm taking Saquon or Aaron Rodgers. Most likely Saquon because we can get that Baker Mayfield for free. If you don't know about that, go watch my last video that I just posted. And Cooks. So Saquon and Cooks, good duo right there. Definitely won't mind doing that. Gold player pack, another quick sell, 15k. When do the rewards get like really good? That Saquon's pretty good though. 84 overall power pass, that's gonna be really good right there. A lot of good players you can get with that. This one's okay. That's Darius Slay, Myles Garrett, and TJ Watt. And obviously, guys, these are the packs for these levels. So level 26 Mutt level, they're gonna be able to get these. What's the next one? That is 15k. That's good. 82 overall, 84. Okay, so they give me like double of every power pass, which I think they did last year. Oh, here we got 84 overall. So that's McCaffrey, Zach Ertz, and I believe Amari Cooper. These are really good also. McCaffrey's going to be an awesome running back slash receiver. Even Ertz is a good option at tight end. Double pro packs, honestly. Free pro packs, I'll take that all day. 20k coin quick sell. So they're giving you lots of opportunities, which I like to get. Free elites, free coins, and free packs just by playing the game. Another 82, 84. So you can get you're going to get three solid upper tier elite players if you use them on the 84s correctly. And here you can get Le'Veon Bell, believe Chris Harris, and D-Law. So you can get D-Law, Le'Veon Bell, and Chris Harris. I'll probably go Chris Harris there because I think I'm taking Saquon. He has the better stats of the two. Another coin quick sell. This one's going to be 20k. 85 to 86 is gonna be really good. This is where you can get like the better overall plays. You can get a Zeke. Can't get Gurley. I don't know them off the top of my head. The database is down right now, and obviously the auction block isn't exactly that reliable right now. But trust me, guys, these rewards are pretty awesome. A gridiron pack. What else is there? 25K quick sell. 85 to 86 overall power pass. 85 overall, that's going to be, I believe, Miles Jack, if I'm correct. And oh, I don't want to say Pat Pete. Don't quote me on this one, but that's Cameron Jordan. Gridiron pack. 25K coin quick sell. And then 87 to 88 overall power pass. That's the banger pass, guys. But that's about it. This video has been pretty long. So, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, go check out my first, second, and now my third video of the day for Madden 20. Grind these out. I'm going to be consistently uploading about 3 to 5 videos a day, hopefully, on Madden 20. Hope you guys are enjoying. If you guys are new, make sure to subscribe. Going to be grinding out the rest of Madden 20. You're not going to want to miss this. Also, guys, make sure to get this video to 100 to 150 likes or anywhere above. Doesn't matter. And I'll be dropping a bundle pack opening on my main account when that officially works and the pre-order thing stops being ass. And also, comment down below 15K and I'll be giving away 15K to a random commenter if we hit the like goal. So, guys, in essence, we're about to be grinding. So, make sure to subscribe. You won't want to miss it. I'm out. See you guys in the next video.